Kidsway Studios, what's up and welcome in. Hey, Pastor Julian coming at you, and we are in a brand new series. And you might have already kind of noticed, like, this trophy here that I have in my hand. Like, trophies and medals and prizes are so absolutely awesome. You can win them for many, many things. And it's awesome because whether it's sports or whether it's a certain type of achievement with school or something else, we always talk about the trophy and we always talk about that end result and how amazing it is to have won something and earned that prize. But here's the thing. Not a lot of people talk about the practice that it took to be able to be as good as you can be and work your best to make sure that you are able to earn that end result of first place, first prize, or whatever it is. It took practice to earn that achievement. And you know, that's what we're going to be talking about in our brand new series called 5K. It's all about running the race. And any runner will tell you that it takes practice to be able to run a race. No matter how good you are, no matter what level you're on, you have to practice. And hey, practice isn't just something for sports. Practice is something that we can use even in our own relationship with God. We can practice. And as we're gonna be talking about practice, we're gonna be talking about one word that is essential and absolutely needed for practice. And that word is commitment. Check this out. This is how we're defining commitment for this month. Commitment is making a plan and putting it into practice. That's right, making a plan and putting it into practice is all about, that's what commitment is, and that's what it's all about when it comes to practicing. You have to make a plan. It helps so, so much. And you know something? God actually gives us a plan to practice. We're gonna hear in our Bible story in just a little bit about what exactly that plan is, but today, our big answer is what it's all about. Check this out. Keep practicing what matters most. That is our big answer for today. Can you guys repeat that with me? Say, keep practicing what matters most. Great job. One more time. Say, keep practicing what matters most. Awesome. Keep practicing what matters most. Now, Pastor Julian, what matters most? Because you can ask probably five different people and they might give you five different answers about what it is that matters most. So stay tuned, because in just a little bit, as we go into our Bible story, we're going to talk about what matters most and how we can have a plan to keep practicing it. But for right now, we're going to try our best to shed away any distractions, any worries, or anything that might be pressing on us from this week. Right now, we're going to spend some time in worship and praise. We're going to sing a song to worship Jesus. We're going to move, we're going to groove, we're going to dance, and we're going to have a great time as we prepare for our Bible story today. So stand up out of your seats and let's get ready to have some fun.
Watch the darkness slip away. Put your power on display. Say goodbye to fear and shame.
Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 9, verses 24 through 25.
Did you know that some writers of the Bible talk sports? Well, not every sport, but at least one that you are familiar with. Yep, running. Running has been around ever since, well, since God created people. In fact, the Apostle Paul uses running as an example in one of his letters to the church in Corinth.
In a race, all the runners run, but only one gets the prize. You know that, don't you? So run in a way that will get you the prize.
Now, Paul is talking about more here than just running, but first you have to understand what it takes to run a long race. Let's say you want to run a marathon. That's 26.2 miles. There's no way you can just hop up off the sofa where you've been playing video games for months and run that far. So, you need a plan. When I was preparing for my first marathon, I found this plan. I started training more than 4 months ahead of the race, and I started with just a few miles at a time. Once you've got a plan, well, then you gotta move. That means short runs, long runs, and cross-training to work other muscles and prevent injury. Next up, you've got to fuel. Plenty of water, of course. Plus, you need healthy carbs for your long runs, like bananas. And maybe some spaghetti and meatballs.
What's the last part of your training? Get ready for it. Rest.
If you don't rest and let your body recover, you'll get burnt out or injured. The last few days before a marathon, you don't even run at all. Oh, yeah. Running a long race is no joke. But Paul says what we're doing right now, you and me, is even more important.
All who take part in the games train hard. They do it to get a crown that will not last. But we do it to get a crown that will last forever. So I do not run like someone who doesn't run toward the finish line. I do not fight like a boxer who hits nothing but air.
Paul packs a lot of weight into just a few sentences. Whether you planned it or not, we are all running a race right now. Okay, so that's a little crazy. Clearly, I'm standing here talking to you, and you aren't outside running laps either. But Paul is talking about a way of life, a journey. We're all focused on the finish line, life forever with Jesus. But in the meantime, every step along the way is important as we live out what matters most. Jesus reminded his followers,
"Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your mind. Love your neighbor as you love yourself."
Yep. Love God, love others. That's what matters on this journey together. But just like you can't skip from jogging one lap around the school gym to running a 26.2 mile race, you're gonna need some practice.
Your Love God, Love Others marathon needs a training plan.
Now, none of us have it all figured out, but here are four important things to start with. In fact, you may already be doing some of them. First point, hear. God is the master teller of this amazing story. He's the author of this whole race, so the most important thing is learning to hear from God. That means digging into God's word and hearing the stories and wisdom from people who walked with him. And you can also hear from God from people around you in your life who know and follow him. Now, here's the second step in training for our Love God, Love Others marathon. Pray. Okay, when you hear pray, you might think,
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
Truth is, you don't need fancy words to pray. You can talk to God anytime, anywhere, about anything, just like talking to your mom or your best friend. Now let's take a look at point three in our training plan, talk.
Hello out there!
Tell other people what God has been up to in your life, what's changing, how you're learning to love others better. And here's the final point in your Love God, Love Others training plan. Live. Live for God. Let his love fill up every part of your life, at home, at school, at church, even when your dad makes you stop reading your book to play a game with your little sister. Hear, pray, talk, live. That's how you practice loving God and loving others. As Paul wrote,
So run in a way that will get you the prize. We do it to get a crown that will last forever.
And when you do, you will live out Paul's wisdom to the Corinthians and win the race.
Are you hurting and broken within? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. cross as you wait for the crown. Tell the world of the treasure you found.
Kidsway, thank you so much for worshiping and spending this time with us. It truly is such an amazing thing that we get to do here each and every Sunday, or whatever day you might be finding us, or whatever day you might be joining us. It is a pleasure to be here and an honor to worship God with you. But hey, we have to talk about what we just heard in that Bible story because it was amazing. And if you can remember, if you've been with us for a while, back to the very first big answer of the year, our big answer was love God and love others. And we mentioned to you at that time that this was so important in the Bible. God says that this is the most important commandment. Love God and then love others. We mentioned that we were going to be talking about it throughout the entire year, and here we are again talking about it. This is the most important thing. Our big answer says keep practicing what's most important. Actually, it says it a little bit different. It says keep practicing what matters most. Can you say that with me? Say keep practicing what matters most. One more time. Keep practicing what matters most. And what matters most is loving God and loving others. And if we want to practice this, we can actually plan for it. And we, in our story, we heard that God actually kind of gives us a plan, kind of gives us a layout to help us to be able to do that. We can hear from God. That's step one, right? We can hear from God. And if you want to hear from God, there's no better way than to read His Word. The more we know God's Word and the more familiar we are with it, the more we'll know if it's Him that's talking to us. So we can hear from God, right? And then we can pray to God. We can talk to Him about whatever it is that's going on in our lives, whether it's good, whether it's bad, whether it's troubling, whether it gives us worry or something that makes us afraid. We can pray and talk to God. So we got hear, pray, and then talk again. We can talk to others about God. This helps us and it helps others know who God is and how He can help them and how much He loves them. And then finally, we can live for God, right? We have a memory verse that tells us that living for God is the most important thing that we can do. Check this out. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8, it says, training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises help for the life you are now living and the life to come. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. I'm going to read that one more time. Training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises help for the life you are in now living and the life to come. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. Being godly has more value in it than anything else we can be. And that is something that we can practice with what we just went over. We can hear from God. We can pray to Him. We can talk to others about Him. And we can live for Him. When we do this, we are showing love to God and love to others. And that is practicing what matters most. Kidsway, I hope that you guys are having a great time, and I hope your day goes fantastic no matter how much is left in it. And remember, when you're questioning something, when you don't know what to do, ask yourself, how can I love God and love others in this time? What can I do to show God love and show others that I love them too? Kidsway, we're praying for you guys. We love you guys so much. We can't wait to see and hear from you whenever that may be. But I hope and I pray that you guys are doing good, that your families are doing good, and we'll catch you guys on the next one. Bye. Hey, wait. Before you go, I have to tell you about something absolutely amazing that's happening next month. Vacation Bible School. June 7th through June 10th, that's a Monday through Thursday, we are going to be having our VBS, and it's going to be absolutely awesome. Yes, I might be a little biased, but I definitely want you there. You can register as a student or you can register as a volunteer. There's some more details on our website. The link to our website will be in the description below. You can go to bridgeway.tv. Once you get to the website, there'll be some prompts that you can follow to sign up your child as an attendee for VBS, or like I said, you can sign up as a volunteer if you have interest there. Please, 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 if you have any questions about it, you can email kidsway@bridgeway.tv and we'll be happy to answer any questions you may have. First through fifth graders, make sure you check it out. Trust me, you're not gonna wanna miss it. But like I said, our description to the link to our website is in the description below, and we will see you guys next time. Bye.